All right, guys, we have a couple of beautiful days here. We're just kind of doing spring cleanup, and a lot of you guys have been asking about the solar tracking system. You were curious if I ever got it fixed, if I replaced that actuator, if the actuator was actually the problem. I put it in a fixed position so it could be in the most ideal situation or position, just stationary. And I haven't gone back to it. Well, now that I have a few minutes here, I'm going to throw this actuator on here and see if that was, in fact, the issue. Inch linear actuator. All right, guys, so if you watched our video, sorry the lighting's bad, I can't do anything about it underneath the solar array here. So if you watched one of my videos over the winter, solar failure, this actuator got stuck, so the array was pointing straight west, which doesn't do me any good. I would be missing like 80% of my sunshine for the day. So in the winter time, I needed it the most because every little bit of light counted. But the tracking system doesn't really track shade or like overcast sunshine anyway. So it doesn't really matter. It tracks the sun really well. So if this would be your only array and you wanted to make the most of a sunny day, I would recommend the system still. $42 part isn't the end of the world. Hopefully the computer board isn't the issue and we don't have more problems than that. I'm sure the computer board and all that stuff, I'm sure that's $100 to $200 part as opposed to a $42 actuator. But here's just a pin, little cotter pin holding it in that I took out that one already. Same thing right here. So I'll just pull this out. So again, once I pull these pins, this is completely free floating. People suggested that I flip this around and put the motor up here. I don't know if that's possible. Maybe I'll try that. That way water can't get in from the top. So maybe we'll try that. So I gotta hold this and pull the pins and all right. Alright guys, wires coming down here to the control board. That's where it goes in and out. I don't remember if black was supposed to be on top or bottom. Worst case scenario, I just have to swap these real quick. So I'm not 100% sure which one goes where, but all it does is reverse the polarity and make it go the other direction. Watch this though, guys. You'll giggle about this. And some of you guys told me this, so I felt kind of silly after I did this. Not silly, but like, I can't sit around and research everything all the time. I kind of like to fix things on my own or break things in this case. This actuator must have just been frozen because, like, from the temperature. Because watch, I have this little 10-watt solar panel and I don't feel like stripping these far away from each other, but watch. Hear that? It actually is working too. If But I broke it inside, so it's not gonna work. So check this out, guys. There's power, obviously power going through, 12 volts going through the solar panel. Watch. Oh, what happened? Probably maxed out. So let's reverse the polarity. What happened?
No, Scout. Let's not chase the birdie.
Well, maybe I burned it out. I think you guys heard it before it stopped working. Anyway, I hooked this up to the solar panel. You heard it running a minute. It's probably maxed out because I tore apart the little plastic thing that slides in and out, so it's stationary. But there's gonna be no way I can fix it, because especially for 42 bucks, I'm not gonna be able to fix it. But I was hoping to have that one as a backup to just swap in there if this happens again next winter. Anyway, let's put power to the system and see if the new one is fixing the problem. Don't touch that, buddy. You get zapped. Low voltage, but you get zapped. Come here, buddy. Oh, uh-oh. I forgot that it would be in auto mode. That one's way quieter than the other one was. All right, so it went right into auto mode. I just forgot that it would do that. So yeah, it's obviously hooked up right. Because now it's facing right at the sun. So I obviously hooked it up right. Or the right direction. And it was just that actuator. So let's just double check everything. So this button, I don't have the face on right now, but this is manual mode, MT. This would be west. Oh wait, east. Moving east. Moving west. How much quieter that one is than listen to this one. Maybe it's because it says this one's lifting, but I guess that's pretty quiet when it goes down. This has a whole different sound to it. Alright guys, problem solved. Not a big problem, but still kind of an annoyance. So I'm gonna put the face back on this. If you guys have any questions about this system, I still haven't set this thing up to auto track back to flat at night. There was a gentleman on YouTube that made a good video. I think his channel name was Solo Jim. Jim Solo Jim, I think. I watched his video and it explained it very easily how to program this to, you know, to make the parameters so at night it goes back to flat. But yeah, I haven't done that yet, so I'll have to watch his video again. I'll try to find it and link it in this video so you guys can watch it. If you have one of these and you want to figure out how to get everything programmed 100%. I got the parameters set to higher, so it doesn't move as frequently. But again, I didn't fix the parameters to go flat at night. So I just kind of come out here at night and put it back flat, or at least put it facing south, straight south. So then in the morning, it picks up the sun perfect. Just like one of my little habits or little tasks for the night. So, all right, well, let's put this faceplate back on. right, all set. So another thing I get a lot of questions about this system is, does it need its own battery? Because you could very easily, when I buried the PV wires from the solar over to the solar shed, or, you know, from the panels over to the solar shed, I could have run a smaller wire to run power to this computer. But I have this trolling motor, deep cycle battery just sitting around. It's not good for batteries to sit anyway, so I have it hooked up to this. And I just bought one of these little $25 solar panels that, these little $25 Renogy solar panels. It's 10 watts, I believe, and it just alligator clips right to here. It gives us a little trickle charge. So then you don't have to have your own charging system on this, or take it off and recharge it. Last year I just took this battery to the solar shed and charged it two or three times over the summer, but this should take care of this indefinitely. I might have to remount the solar panel because the grass will grow up and stuff here now, but yeah, keeps a trickle charge on this thing all winter long, and it'll take care of us now. Should probably move this battery up closer to the solar array. Anyway, all fixed up, guys. Hope that solves your worries and stuff, and let's get on to the next project. All right.